Drive with confidence. From routine service to complete engine repairs, you can trust the pros at A1 Quick Oil to get you back on the road safely. Drop it off or sit and wait in customer-friendly comfort. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars. We fix them.
Well, speaking of projects, there's a big sewer project that's in the works.
Again, that's correct. It's part of the water sector program through the state. This will be the second round of the applications. We were not funded the first round. The amount available in the pot was $350 million last year. This year it's $450 million. We have reviewed the application as originally submitted, brushed it up a little bit, added a few things. It's a project. The total project is about almost $6.1 million. And of that $6.1 million, the city will be putting up a little over $2 million. That helps the rating process. The project consists of lift station renovations, but primarily the upgrade of the sewer wastewater treatment facility on the south end of town. But it's very competitive. We feel pretty strong about it, strongly that we can be funded this time. As we understand, the Water Sector Committee will be reviewing the applicant. The state agencies that assign some of the points are examining the applications now. There will be a presentation to the Water Sector Committee as to the projects that rated the highest, and then we expect an award to be made to the successful recipients by the end of the year. Thus, you know, probably mid-year next year we'll be under construction with it.
So it just goes to show that a sewer system is something that you have to always be applying for future grants to keep it up.
Ken, you know, and Ponchatoula is, I think, not unique in this problem. You know, most municipalities have the problem with their sewer system. It's very expensive. It's maintenance all the time. You know, all of us, all municipalities fight infiltration from the rain. And, you know, we completed a project about 3 years ago that eliminated a good portion of that. But now with all the construction that's gone on and all of the utility companies that are installing lines underground, you know, we have those problems. We had a contractor this week bore through a sewer force main. So those things happen. It's just the way it is in the sewer world.
So how is it that Ponchatoula doesn't have the problems that, say, a Hammond has had in sewer?
Ken, I guess we're our area is smaller, but yes, Hammond seems to have had their share of problems. Some areas worse than other, and we have areas in Ponchatoula that, you know, some areas never have a problem. The outside areas or the areas in the low portion of the city have problems every time we have a huge rain. Luckily, they've been at a minimum, but we do get them every once in a while. We get complaints that people have had sewer backup in their homes. Some people have learned to take off a clean out cap, and that's a DEQ frowns on that quite a bit. But rather than having sewer in your backyard rather than in your house, I think is an option.
So, speaking of problems that Hammond and Ponchatoula both have, you're getting a new garbage contractor, correct?
Ken, I'm not so sure. The council has at our last council meeting, determined or rejected all bids that we got on the RFP that we've worked with Hammond on, and chose to negotiate with our existing contractor. They have put it in our attorney's court to put some very strong restrictions on the garbage company that they will have to meet. So it's not over yet, but it's close to being over.
So what will happen October 1st? Isn't that the date it expires?
Ken, if it goes as the council is directed at this point, it'll be the same company, so it won't be. Our meeting is not until October the 3rd when they'll make their determination. We have some standby plans should the worst happen and we find ourselves with no collector. We have one collector that said that they would move in immediately. The only kind of trick here is we would be using the old company's garbage containers. I think we've kind of worked. I don't think the that's going to be a big problem. It could be, but we'll just have to see what happens on the 3rd, Ken.
So you're expecting to stick with Amwaste?
That seems to be the way that the council is moving, but they are very, I think they're very, a couple of the councilmen are very adamant about their performance, and if we continue with them, that there are going to be some pretty stiff requirements for performance. The day that we had our council meeting, they were still picking up garbage at 9 o'clock Monday afternoon on the Monday evening on the west side. So that is really kind of unacceptable, but there's breakdowns, and, you know, the garbage business is trashy.
Well, in the meantime, your sales tax receipts seem to know no bounds. It keeps going up, and that's up over a year ago when we were trumpeting a big increase over the year before that.
Yeah, yeah, Ken, it's, you know, our sales tax collections continue to be strong. We're, you know, we increased our projection, monthly projection, by $25,000 a month, and we exceed it every month. We try to be conservative and not too aggressive with what our collection should be, but we're on the positive. We've been on the positive side for the last 5 or 10 years.
Before we close, I mean, the issue of the day appears to be the plan to pump carbon dioxide underneath Lake Maurepas, which the city of Ponchatoula has not been involved in at all. But on the other hand, maybe you should have been. Some are saying that local governments were left out of these plans that were made for the little lake. What do you think?
Ken, it's a sleeper. I tell you, all of a sudden, they're there. We had no input whatsoever. I had no idea that this was going on. You know, maybe that's my fault, but it seems like it's caught a lot of us by surprise. It's interesting. It's alarming to not know exactly all the details. I understand they had quite a presentation at the parish council office meeting last night, and I think there's more to come. There's a lot of questions out there, and a lot of unknowns, and we'll be keeping on top of it to see exactly what's going to unfold here.
We have a meeting coming up. It might be in Ponchatoula. In fact, it probably will be in Ponchatoula.
I got word of that possibly this morning, that they're looking for a venue to have a meeting, and certainly we will make our community center available.
Well, in the meantime, you know, another thing I want to bring up is that every weekend now, it seems like there's some big fun event, calendar of events in Ponchatoula. Even though it's not spring, it's not the festival season, but the goal of having something every weekend in Ponchatoula, why, we're not far from that. Coming up, we've got the Strawberry Strut, mm-hmm, events at Twin Steeples and more.
That's correct, Ken. You know, October is an extremely busy month for us in Ponchatoula. And this weekend, as you mentioned, Twin Steeples has their art market. As we understand, there is over 50 vendors, artists that are bringing their goods. And it's a day and a half. It opens, I think, noon on Friday and all day Saturday. The Twin Steeples board and executive director have been working on it for months. I, and of course, Kim is involved, and there seems to be nothing that is undone at this point. I mean, they are actually fairly caught up. They've, like I said, it's been months and months of planning with the board and with the executive director and all the stakeholders.
So just another busy weekend coming up in Ponchatoula.
It will be, and it you know, they were looking at the weather conditions, and early on when we had the storm in the enter the Gulf, and so it looks like somebody else is going to get it this time. You know, we pray for them, but glad it's not here. You know, we're still recovering from Ida. There are still things out there, visible things that we're working on, and we definitely didn't want to have another one.
You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.